What's up, beautiful people? Today we've been blessed with another Lili's film, this time called The Movie. And first of all, she's one of my old biases, one of the reasons next to Blackpink I got into K-pop. Second, for me, she is one of the best, not if the best dancer in K-pop at the moment. And third of all, till now, all her Lili's films were amazing and just basically showcasing her ability in dancing, her versatility in dancing. Until now, they were all different. So if you haven't saw yet, I did actually react to all those Lili films too till now. I think 4 or 5 they were. I'm gonna link them up in the info box if you haven't saw those yet. But yeah, I'm freaking excited. I don't know if I'm gonna be alive after this video, after this watch. I feel like I'm gonna die like multiple times in this video. Yeah, I think we're just gonna jump right in and watch the Lili's film, The Movie. Ooh, black and white. Okay, okay, okay. Oh no. Oh, I saw her outfit. Oh no. Okay, I'm definitely gonna be dying throughout this 3 minutes. I'm sorry for everyone who's watching. Ooh. Ooh, interesting with the gas masks. In a suit. Really? Okay. Bruh. It didn't even start it. What the hell? Ooh. Hey. Yeah, it's true, true, bro, true. Ooh. Ooh. That wave right there. Oh. Ooh. Ooh, the flow, the groove right there. Ah. Ah. Yo. How? That was clean, that was so smooth. That was way too smooth, bro. Now I already thought the suit was already too much. Now we got even high heels choreography. Gosh. She really was like, yeah, let's just kill every Blink, every Lisa fan. Let's just kill them. Oh. Mm-hmm. Bro. Bro. Yes. Hey. Hey. Ooh. That was nice. Those little stops at the build. Okay. Bro. Oof. It like it's actually just shows her like her going 180, her ability to go 180, like going from tomboyish like the song says to like really sexy high heels choreography without like in a blink of an eye. Bro. And then also like the black and white in the video was so freaking cool. Yeah, the song was freaking dope actually. Destiny Rogers Tomboy. I didn't even know that song, so definitely gonna have to check that one out, but she really was like, okay, let's just kill everyone today. Like just like I love that in this one, like I said, she showed 180, like first that more tomboyish suit, groove, hip-hop-ish style. Actually really kind of Justin Timberlake style, I would say, or Chris Brownish style from their performances and stuff. And then totally switching 180 to then the heels choreography that I didn't saw. Like I thought really it's gonna be 3 minutes of that style, but this time they mixed it, which is different also to the other Lili's film where she just focused on one dance style. So I freaking love that. That really, it's like basically really two sides to something, and she just looks amazing and cool and sexy with every single style. Like, I don't think there is something that Lisa can't dance to and doesn't look good or can't execute good. Like, those grooves, those lines, those waves at the grooving part with the suit, so amazing. How smooth she basically just jumped, had some old school moves right there. Like, her smoothness, her lightness throughout that, it was like, for her it was like just like a normal morning to execute something like that, and that makes such a great dancer. That's why Lisa is such a great dancer. Her execution is so amazing that she makes it look easy, choreographies like that, even though like those little executions and those grooves and those lines and those extended arms and everything is really hard to do. And then the same thing goes with the heels. Then she went to a more like sensual body wave. Like, they had body, both of those dance styles had body waves, but the executions are different, because that's what makes those different styles, those different styles. But they use, you know, the same ground moves, like, you know, two step or body waves or stuff like that. It's just how you execute is different in this, those styles. And you can dissect, which I probably will, the body wave, which in the grooving part she had a little bit more of a little bit more of a coolness to it, a little bit more of a hit, a little bit hit through. And then in the heels it was a little bit bigger and really accenting the ending with the hips a little bit more to really have that sensual feeling. So she really can go to both sides and execute amazingly, and all the facets in between she can do too. That's why, like, it's nothing that she can't do. And bro, this video, like, it has already 3.5 million views at the time I'm recording, so I see why, because this is a masterpiece. This is literally a master. It's literally a movie. I see now why she called it a movie. And yeah, we're gonna watch it a second time just for me to, you know, analyze it a little closer. No other reason behind there. Just me wanna dissect the moves a little bit more. How can someone look so good even through, like, it's just like, I don't even see her that good, but I know she looks amazing. It's just the attitude that she has. I'm a girl's girl. Ooh. I'm a boss in a man's world. Yeah, I can pick and roll past ballerinas, skating through the city with my soul back on. Still be looking pretty with no makeup on. Yeah, okay, already that little section right there. Love how everything is choreographed. Him walking by, taking the snap of the, how you call that, of the fan on the thing of the song. I love that. I love choreographed videos that start like that, that choreograph the normal stuff, like I said, being on in a restaurant and ordering stuff like that. I always find that really creative, how people incorporate, like, yeah, normal life into choreographies, basically, like taking orders or getting something or opening up a fan. And then also the little snap that she has with her hands right there is so nice. The little accent right there. Oof. She's always moving. If you look at her body, it's always moving. Even though she has accents in between, she never stops. It's everything's connected. And that's why she is so smooth. And that's why it feels so light and smooth when she dances. Like, you see that bang, boom. She doesn't like stop it like I just did, stop it and go into the next. Like, she really goes into it and still has enough of an accent that goes into it. And that little wave right there, that little freestyle that she has, is really nice, really smooth. And it just goes, and then she goes into the next. And she only stops when she has that little isolation that she does, where she just walks her fingers. So she really amazingly knows every execution, literally. That just, that little section already tells you how amazing her dancing ability is by her just sitting down, knowing when to connect every move, when to accent something nicely and still, but still not make it stop. And then knowing that, oh, now we have an isolation. Now I have to really just isolate and just move my fingers. And the whole attitude during that, her face so relaxed, just sends you like, oh, it's the easiest thing ever. That turn, so freaking smooth. And also her extended arms right there, nice. Her body also going with it, also finishing the line and not having like the body straight and trying to have it just with your arms. That line, she also like breaks her body a little bit to complement that line. And also, again, the only stop is really here. They wanted to, or Cheshire wanted there to have not a pretty picture to then go into the turn and then into the next move. And before that, they have really a grooving thing where she really really always has a little wave connecting each move till that little stop, turn, and then comes that wave. This whole section is just smooth as fuck. It just moves. It just flows. Which at the down, bro. 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 I didn't know I needed Lisa breakdancing, but I want to see more of that. Like, groundwork amazing too. Bro, it's like, groundwork is, I feel like, not one of the easiest sections of dancing. Like, groundwork, you really have to have a lot of body control and really keep yourself up to make it look light and flow nicely. And Lisa does that too. And this time not in the wave of like a heels choreography groundwork, but more of a, yeah, hip-hop-ish breakdance kind of style right there. And really, the way she can really control her center, keep herself up, is the reason why she can make those light footworks and go up that easily without making it look heavy and hard. And it's also a reason why her dancing looks easy, her execution of this choreography looks easy, even though like that flow before they go down, first of all, Cheshire, bruh, your mind, like, what, like, those old school moves, but really smooth, a little bit closer to the ground, not a lot of too high jumpings, freaking nice. Then center control, always moving, always grooving, never stopping. Ah, it's so good. And Lisa executing it perfectly is just, I swear, there's a reason why those two do the Lilith film together. Cheshire's mind choreographing and everything is just so good. And Lisa's ability to adapt and execute and dance amazingly is just a perfect marriage every single time. And it's just, it's such a freaking eye candy and musicality candy, this whole section, the whole grooving connectivity part. Oh my god. Like, I could be here an hour and dissect that, this whole part right here, like, those old school. And it doesn't stop, like, it's always connected in a way, like, it's so hard, man. Hey. Still, it's actually not stopping. They're still dancing. They have this little chill groove, little pause right there, but it's not that they stopped moving. Like, there's still the same groove going on. It's the same groove that they had the whole section beforehand. And, bruh. Hey. And coming up as if it's nothing. But then we go right. Oof. Yeah. So one big difference between heels and the choreography beforehand is that also her posture is a lot more open, a lot more, yeah, straight right there, also her legs, because when you have heels, you automatically have to do a lot more straighter and beautiful legs. So, yeah, and of course, the usage of more your hips and center core is a lot bigger too. Like in the one beforehand, you use your upper body a lot more to have that groove, and then now you go more into the hips. Underbody section, center body section, of course, beautiful legs and beautiful arms too. So those are the big differences between those styles, and you can see it perfectly with just the beginning of her, like really like having an outstretched leg right there, nearly going into ballet a little bit with that one, just like small right there. So it's really beautiful, shows the contrast from those two perfectly. That one with the head, that accent right there. That hit, boom. And of course, she knows how to hit. I think I went through every execution already that you can do in dancing. That hit, bruh. And then going down again into the ground choreography as if it's nothing. Like, it's not a whole workout or anything. Like, that your abs are gonna be dead after this choreography, just from the whole ground choreographies and yourself holding yourself up, especially in heels, because you have to have that more sensual up, posture that in the other choreography you could cheat a little bit more. In this one, it wouldn't look the same way if you would cheat your posture and your legs, your straight legs. Like, I swear, flexible she's too. I think now we have everything down. I think literally we have every execution, every ability down. I think there's nothing left. Yeah, that's also something I'm asking myself, bruh, come on. Oh, hair choreography, of course, but we got that down too, like her accent with her head to make them swing nicely. Perfect. I don't have anything else to say anymore. Ooh, love that. Nice little like time stoppy, and then a little milk up, a little body wave milk up. Oh, nice. Not only a body milk up, body wave milk up, but also it has still a groove going on. Oh, that smile is so cute. Okay. But yeah, it actually isn't just the body wave. They groove still a little bit, have a little kind of small twerking groove going on, going up. Yeah, that twerking groove, but like a little bounce right there. Like it a lot. Yeah, I'm watching respectfully. Wow, I can't even talk anymore. I don't think it was the best idea to watch it a second time, literally. You see how beautiful her hands are? Like, there is tension till her fingertips, and really up there, really nice, beautiful S line to make that sensual, sexy vibe complete. My God, my God. Hey. Little details like that make a good get dancer an amazing and great dancer. Those little executional details. Hey, dun, dun, dun. That song is so freaking good though. Oh, she actually killed everyone, so it's literally that she killed everyone. Not only in the movie, but also me. So yeah, I gushed over these 3-minute videos for over 10 minutes. I'm really sorry about that, but I hope you guys still enjoyed it. Me gushing over Lisa's dancing again for like 20 minutes probably after editing this. So yeah, she definitely blessed us today. Like, oh my God. I hope you guys enjoyed this not so little reaction to Lisa's Lily's film. the movie. Oh my god, I'm still out of breath. Let me know down in the comments below what you guys thought of the whole movie, of the whole video. I hope you guys have an amazing day. Be safe and don't forget to subscribe, like, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace. Drowning out our sorrows, holy water, lost at sea. Stacking all this baller, I might cop a subway.